art studio, we are talking about taking a drawing on a canvas through to completion as a finished acrylic painting. So this is what I find that I need in order to do that. To begin, I brought in my drawer of acrylic paints from home so that I can have a little bit higher quality than what we use here at school, because this painting will in the end be a gift. I have my canvas with my initial drawing already done on it. I've got my brushes, water, paper towel, my reference pictures, and a palette to mix my paint colors on. For the underwash, you want to have your paints watered down so that they are nice and thin and you can see through them enough to see the lines of your drawing. An underwash gives you a base layer for the painting so that future layers don't show gaps of white canvas through them. It can give you an undertone of the overall feeling you want. So if you wanted an upbeat, happier vibe, you might use yellows and oranges. Some artists will use the colors they want their future shadows to be. For example, there would be a blue underwash if you wanted to have blue tones in the shadows later. And some artists will just do a basic underwash with whatever colors they're going to end up using, which is pretty much what I'm going to do. Another reason, the final reason for me personally, to do an underwash on a painting is so that my pencil stays still. Because as you work, you might notice that the graphite from the pencil will start to move around. It'll bleed a little out of its original line. Putting an underwash will guarantee you that in future layers of paint that are applied, your pencil graphite will not bleed into those colors and make them look grayish. All right, here we go, have fun. Creating a finished artwork is a process. It starts with an idea. When I got the idea for this painting, I quickly put it down, sketched it out on a little piece of paper just so I would remember what the idea was. Once I was ready to begin, I knew I would need some visual references so that my cows looked, you know, more like cows than these cute little critters. So next, I searched the web for some images. I had a few different types of cows and a picture of the Boston skyline for my pictures to look at while I worked. Then I began mapping out my drawing on the canvas that I would use for my final painting. Often when we see paintings in a museum or even like on a calendar or on a wall or anywhere, we just see the finished product and we don't see the whole process. So this is just a way for me to show you that everything really is a process. There's no quick, easy way to get to a finished product or a finished painting in this case without taking the time to think it through and do everything well. In short, step one is to draw your image on your canvas, paper, or whatever you are using as a surface for your painting. I'm creating an acrylic painting on a stretched canvas that is already primed, so I did not have to do that step. If you're using raw canvas, you should prime it first with gesso. So I start by getting my paint, adding water and stirring until it is quite thin. Thank you.
All right, now the next step is to begin applying acrylic paint for the final painting. When I work, I always work back to front, meaning I start with the thing that is farthest away from me as a viewer, which is the background, in this case, the sky showing through behind the buildings. Then I work my way forward. After the sky, I'll complete the buildings with the ones farthest away and then the ones closer into the middle ground. After that, the bridge, followed by the water, the ground, part of the ground is behind the cows, part of it's in front. Then I'll complete the cows and add little bits of grass, maybe coming up to cover tiny bits of their feet. The reason this approach works, and the reason that I do it, is because you want to have the things that are closest to us in the foreground appear to be, well, closer and on top of the things behind it, because in the image they are on top. So what I mean by that is that if I have painted the cows completely, then I decide to go back and paint in the buildings and the bridge and the water, that causes a lot of problems because I would have to so carefully paint this little area so that it doesn't go into the other areas. Whereas if I paint all of the other things first and then the cow, it doesn't matter much if my water went over the horn a little bit or if the building went over the cow's hair, because I'll be then painting over, when this is dry, I'll paint the cow on top and it will cover any strange edges that happened while I was working in the background. All right, so first things first, I will pick some colors to begin my sky and move forward from there.
Thank you.
At this point, I'm pretty much done, but I still have some small details to finish up. For example, I want to add cow spots on the building so it looks like the cows took over Boston. And then the background is a bit too vibrant, and I really want the cows to stand out, so I'll probably do a watered-down white overwash on the entire background, and I think that will give it a fogginess as well as make the cows pop into the foreground of the painting. I'll check back in when I'm done and go over the whole thing. Thanks for watching. All right, in review, we started with a primed canvas, a pencil drawing using visual resources or references for the details of what we need, and then an underwash or underpainting on everything, followed by the final painting working from the background and coming forward, ending with a review, a critique, and adding all of the details or anything that seems unfinished or like things are missing. Just because we start with the background doesn't mean we're not going to go back to it later on, because we are. It's very much a back and forth, a give and take. Thanks for watching and happy painting.